So after the first class we will be seeing the MOS inverter circuit. So in this class we will be basically dealing with the circuit design by using NMOS, PMOS and CMOS transistors. So once we have designed or fabricated the transistor, we will be taking its device to design basic VLSI circuits. So starting with the inverter. So why we are going to have inverter? Because inverter is the most fundamental logic gate that can be used to perform Boolean functions that have one variable. Okay, so for inverter we will be using one variable Boolean function, and also to have a complex circuits, like to represent a complex circuit, we will be requiring other gates, the basic logic gates. And once we have gone through the MOS inverter design, so whatever method we are going to use or steps we will be using to characterize the MOS inverter or to identify or to find out the principles, like how it is working and on what principles it is working, the similar logic will be implemented to other gates also, and the similar logic can be implemented to other complex circuits also. Okay, so that's why we will be taking consideration of inverter design, that is the basic form of a digital circuit. Okay, so the first we will be starting with the DC characteristic analysis. So we will be analyzing only the DC characteristics, and then we will be analyzing the dynamic or transient characteristics. So your DC means, so any analysis is there on that, if we are making it to have, like it is working on very low frequency, then that analysis will be considered a DC characteristics, or the steady state value, steady state analysis, the DC analysis is also can be represented like it is steady state value, steady state analysis. Like, so any input we are applying, suppose a voltage is there, okay, so this is a voltage source, so suppose V input is there, so and this V input is, suppose it is given by this, once it is 5 volt and after some time it is having 0 volt. So in the this waveform we are seeing like it is having a high value, you know, 5 value in between, suppose this is T1 and this is T2. Okay, so in actual, to have this stable value of 5 volt for this duration of time, there is some time taken by this voltage, this input voltage. So whatever the input voltage is there, its magnitude is 5 volt, it will be taking some time to rise from zero level. So starting with, so once there is nothing is connected to this input voltage, it will be at value 0. So to get 0 to high value, that is maximum 5 volt, it takes some time. Okay, some time will be taken by this voltage source to reach from 0 to highest value, that is 5 volt. Okay, so in this analysis we will be only analyzing like once this circuit or this voltage has reached 5 volt, then what will be the analysis, what will the result, what will the output. Okay, so whatever any input any transistor is there, whatever supply voltage we are giving, so that supply voltage we are analyzing is at the steady state condition, like once we have applied 5 volt. So we are just considering that, like once the 5 volt has reached, then what will be the response of this that circuit, or we are analyzing it for 0 volt. So once from 0 or from 5, it has reached to 0 volt. So it has stable out at the either 0 logic or 1 logic. In between, what is the transition and in that transition range, what is its behavior, the circuit behavior, we are not going to analyze that, okay, in this DC analysis. And when you are at a low logic low or high before switching, it is a DC condition. So before switching, whatever logic is there, what is stable logic is there, that will be either low or high, that will be considered as DC logic. The transient can be thought of as a perturbation of DC, since valid logic levels are a range of voltages. It is a tolerance system. So what happens? So once there is a perturbance, means any disturbance is there, any ups and downs are there. So if that is there, that will be because of the your transient variations. So we are not considering that transient variations, like if it is going to have 5 volt, some high is there or low is there, again it is going 5 volt. So we are not going to consider this. We will be only considering like it has reached the maximum value. If it is 5 volt, it is always in 5 volt. Or if it is 5 volt, some disturbance, after disturbance, it has reached to 0 volt. So either we will be considering only the stable one, that is 5 volt, or after stable at the either low high logic or low logic, we will be considering only these two logic values only, or states. So this will be your either steady state at high logic or steady state at low logic. So in inverter, so this is your basic symbol of inverter, and A input is given, we will be getting a B output that will be represented like A bar. Okay, so this is the invert of or complement of your A input, and its truth table is given like A is 0 and 1, then B will be getting is opposite to A, that is if it is 0 it will be 1, it is 0, and this will be its characteristics. We call it voltage transfer characteristics, so or we call it voltage transfer curve, either of these two we call it. And this is for ideal inverter. So what is ideal inverter? So inverter, if it is ideal, so if VDD is of the V input is having a range of 0 to VDD, then in half of the voltage of that VDD, that is VDD by 2, this logic is 0 to VDD by 2 will be considered as logic 0. So this is logic 0 input. So this will be your logic 0 for input. And after any voltage that is in between VDD by 2 and VDD will be considered as logic 1 as the input. So once we are giving logic 0 as input, then output will be opposite to that, that will be 1. So this 1 will be given by the VDD value. Okay, so it will be having the VDD value, that is the maximum value possible for the high. So for high, if maximum value we are taking VDD, so high will be there when low logic is implemented. So this value will be logic 1 output. So okay, this will be your logic 1 output. Similarly, if VDD by 2 and VDD is the range of input, that will be considered as logic 1. So if we are providing logic 1 as input, the output will be logic 0. So its curve will be the for ideal one, at the starting at low logic input, output will be high. Okay, so similarly in the next half, once the input is high, output will be at low logic. Okay, so this is the ideal curve, but this is not happen in case of practical inverter circuits. So what happens in case of practical inverter circuits? The practical inverter circuit characteristics is given like it will be at high, and to get a zero, it will be taking some time to go to the value zero. Okay, so this is how an inverter characteristic of a practical inverter could be like. Either this could be there, or any other will be there. Okay, so the other one could be like that is okay. So this is the or similarly we call it another one. So these are three different practical characteristics, practical voltage transfer curve, VDC curves of a practical inverter is there. So ideal is having, we can see from there, ideal is having high value for certain time, for certain input voltage, and suddenly it drops to zero. Okay, so at this point, if we consider the gain, if we find out the gain, what is the gain? So gain will be given by D V output by D V input. So this will be considered as the gain. So at this point, this is a constant one. Okay, so this will be considered as a high gain because this dv by dt is having a magnitude, this one, if we can call it the slope. So this slope is basically zero here, okay, or a constant value. So once we find out, so whatever the difference we will be finding out here, the slope will be the minimum value. And similarly at the logic zero, it is having a slope, that is a zero slope. But in between the transition, there will be a finite slope. So this transition range, whatever this transition range is called, it is having finite slope. So at this point, it is having a constant, or we call it as zero slope. Okay. So based on the slope, slope will be considered as the analysis parameter we will be analyzing later on. So in the inverter, we will be basically seeing the noise immunity. So how the noise immunity is calculated, and what is the meaning of noise immunity? So noise immunity and noise margins. So noise immunity and noise margins are similar terms. So the noise margin is like, what is the range of inputs? Okay, so this noise margin could be in terms of voltage range. This noise margin is like a range of input voltages. Okay, so this is the range of input voltages that can be considered as a valid input logic or whatever range of voltages are there, either input voltage or output voltage. Similarly, it is invalid output logic also. So this noise margin is given in terms of range of input voltages or range of output voltages that provides a valid input logic and a valid output logic. So basically here what happens, there are different voltage terms or there are parameters, we call it VOH, VOL, VIL. Okay, so this VOH is considered as output high logic. So this is VOH, that is output high logic, and this VOL is output low logic. Okay, similarly VIL will be input low logic. Okay, and VIH will be considered as input high logic. So in case of digital circuits, so what happens, we will be having a range of inputs and outputs that will be considered as a valid range. So suppose this is V input and this is your V output. Okay, so the input can be varying from 0 to a value that is VDD. Okay, the maximum value could be VDD. Similarly, the output will be varying from 0 to a value that is VDD. Okay, but all the inputs, so what will the input range up to which the input will be considered as low logic is called your, this is called your VIL. So this is voltage input low. That means this is low logic of input voltage. So if any voltage is there, input voltage is there that is having a range from 0 to VIL will be considered as logic 0. This will be considered as logic 0. Okay. Similarly, point is there in between a 0 VIL and VDD. There is, this is a point. We call it VIH. VIH is the voltage. After that, what will be the range of input voltage that will be considered as logic high? Logic high or logic 1. So to have input a logic 1, the input voltage should be ranging from VIH to VDD. Similarly, to have an input that is to be considered as logic 0, then that input voltage should be ranging from zero to VIL value. Okay, so this is VIL value. If input is ranging from 0 to VIL, it will be considered as logic 0. Similarly, there is the case with respect to output also. So output is having like this, your V output will be having VOH. So this is higher than your VIL. So higher than VIL will be VOH, that will be considered as logic 1. So this range VOH to VOL will be considered as the your high logic value. And similarly, the VIL will be, VOL, that is output low logic, will be between 0 to VOL. It will be less than VIL value. Okay, so this is the range. So these two voltages are there that is used to define the noise margin. Okay, so this range is there. So how much this range is there, based on that we will be finding out like what is the noise immunity in the system is there, and how the noise margin value is being different and how it is being varied. Okay, so there are four value voltage parameters, so we will be seeing one by one. So suppose any combination of inverter is there. So this is first inverter, this is second, this is third. So in between these three inverters, we will be connecting one inverter by two by using interconnect. So interconnect is like a wire. If we are using a wire to connect inverter one to inverter two, similarly inverter two and inverter three is connected by another interconnect, that is a wire. Okay. So in practical cases, what happens is, suppose we have given VOH as input to inverter 1. VOH is given as input to inverter 1. Okay, so from there we can see like VOH is at this point. So VOH is higher than your VIL value. So whatever input that is having VOH is being given to input, then that input will be considered as logic 1. So this will be considered as logic 1 as the input. So logic 1 input will be there at this inverter input. So once we are giving logic 1 as the input, the output will be at logic low. So output will be logic low. So that output is, suppose VOL is there. So this VOL will be there at the logic output. So VOL will be output. So once the VOL is there, and there is some interconnect, so because of this interconnect, there could be some noise. So this noise will be having some voltage. So this, suppose this is VN, that is because of noise voltage. So this noise voltage plus the output voltage, that is VOL, will be added to each other. Okay, so suppose this noise has been added. So once we have added this noise, so what will be there? So this, suppose noise is very high at that time, then this noise could be made like, once we have given VOL, it can have either, if it is positive noise, VOL is added, so then this VOL can be greater than VOL. Suppose VOL is there and this is your VIL, so whatever noise we are adding, after adding it could cross the VIL value. So suppose after adding it is greater than VIL, or the other possibility is after adding the noise it is having VOL, after adding the noise it is less than VIL. Okay, so any input is there, any input voltage at this point will be considered as valid, it will be considered as valid only when the V input is less than VIL. Okay, if V any input that is less than VIL, so this will be the case. So in this case this will be considered as logic 0 at the input of inverter 2. But suppose after adding the noise this voltage at this point is more than VIL, so any voltage that is higher than VIL value, so because this is the valid logic range from 0 to VIL, if after adding the noise this input voltage has reached in the range of VIL and VIH, then this will be considered as an invalid. Okay, so if input V input here is greater than VIL, this will be considered as invalid input. So after providing this as the input, okay, the output will not be providing, the output of this inverter 2 will not be a correct output. So the noise should be considered, and that noise should be affecting the input voltage so that it should be ranging below VIL to be considered as logic 0. So once the noise is very high, it could cross the range of VIL and could reach into this region, then this input logic will be considered a logic high, and this logic high will be affecting the inverter 2 output as an error. Okay, so here an error will be there if this input logic is being misinterpreted by this inverter 2. Okay, so this is how the noise is affected. Similarly, suppose a VOH is the output, and after that we are having an interconnect and some noise introduction is there. So once we are going to add noise, okay, so if after adding the noise, because VOH is there, either it could be plus or minus. Okay, so based on the noise value it could be plus minus. So after adding, suppose this value is less than VIH, okay, and or it could be VIH higher than VIH. So to have as the input to be considered as logic 1, the input of the third inverter will always be higher than VIH. Agar VIH se jyada hai, then only this input will be considered as a valid input. Okay, to have the valid input, that is valid high input, the V input should be greater than VIH. So if V input at this point is higher than VIH, then only this inverter will be interpreting this input as a high input, and it will be providing logic low, that is VOL, as the output. If this is not case, if the input at this input voltage at this point is less than VIH, then what will happen, whatever output we will be getting at this output point, output node, this will not be a predictable, or you can say a valid output, or output that can be interpreted either with the zero or not, okay, or high logic. So if we are providing any input that is in this range, so any input that is in the range this one will be considered as invalid input. Okay, so once we are providing an invalid input to an inverter or any logic gate, that logic gate will not be providing a valid output. It will not provide a valid output, or we can call it the output will not be valid output. Okay, so there should be, or we call it a unpredictable okay. So if we are not giving the valid output, valid input, then the output that we will be getting will be an unpredictable output. It could be either 0 or 1. So there is no surety either that inverter will be providing what type of output. Like if we are giving a logic 0, logic or logic high, logic 1 as the input, output will be 0. This is for sure for an inverter. But if we are not providing either 0 or 1, so we are not sure like what is the input we have provided, then we cannot predict what will be the output, either it is 0 or 1. So it is like unpredictable. Okay, it becomes unpredictable. So this is how the role of interconnect is there to affect the circuit performance in case of digital circuit analysis. And the noise margin. So noise margin is like there should be a range of inputs, okay, so that range should be having a valid input combination. Okay, so there should be the noise margin, there should be a margin in the input to provide a valid input to the inverter circuit or any digital circuit, so that their output is a predictable output, or the output is a valid output. Okay, so here the similar analysis is there, and the noise margin is basically denoted by the term NM, that is noise margin, and it is of two types. So noise margin will be of two types. So noise margin range will be noise margin low and noise margin high. So it is noise margin low will be given by VIL minus VOL. So VIL minus VOL will be considered as low noise margin, and highest noise margin will be considered as VOH minus VIH. So VOH, this is VOH minus VIH. So from this figure we can see like if this is the input and this is the output. Okay, so the input range, this will be considered as logic 0 as the input, and this will be considered as the logic 1 as the input. This range, from ranging from here to here, similarly from here to here, okay, this is your 0. But in case of output, because this is your output and this is your input, in case of output, a range between 0 to VIL will be considered as logic, this will be considered as logic 0 as the output. Okay, and similarly this will be considered as logic 1 as the output. So in between this so suppose any logic is there and it is having VIL value this one, and this is the VOL value. So whatever this range is there, this range will be considered as low noise margin. So this is noise margin low, is given by this formula. And similarly the difference of VOH and VIL will be represented by this. So this will be your high noise margin. So in the ideal inverter circuit, this noise margin is maximum, that is equals to VDD. And in case of all other practical cases, we have to calculate what is noise margin, and based on the noise margin, how much variation we can put to the input so that the obtained output, obtained input to the logic circuit is a valid input. Okay, so and also there is a term called transition region. So this is the transition region. So this transition region is providing a range of input voltages that is having a difference from VIL minus VIL. So this transition region, if we recall the transfer curve, voltage transfer curve. This is V out and this is V input of an inverter. So if this is the range, so here this is high, this is low, in between that, this is considered as the transition region. Okay, so this is your transition region. In the transition region, whatever input we are providing, we are not sure because the output will be ranging from this range. Okay, so this will be output range. So this output range will not be clearly indicating whether it is logic 1 or logic 0. Okay, so it is not clearly showing us like if it is logic 1 or logic 0. So this transition range is the range we should be avoiding to give as a input. It should be avoided. So this transition range, whatever transition range is there, we should be avoiding input that should not be reaching in this transition range, because if input has reached in this transition range, then we will not be able to predict like what will be the output of that circuit. Okay, so this is the transition range, and it should be reduced. So if transition is transition region is minimum 10, the noise margin will be high. Okay, so if this is the transition region, then the noise margin will be high. So to have a better inverter, we should be having a better noise margin, and to have a better noise margin, we should be reducing this transition region. Okay, and the next point is, like, we are just considering, so suppose any output is there that is being affected by a noise. Okay, so it will be a function of the input voltage also and the noise voltage also. Okay, so that output will be, after adding the noise consideration, this will be the function. If we expand it, it will be like V out dash will be equals to a function of input plus dV output by dV in into the change in V noise. Okay, so plus some other high terms are there that is being neglected. Okay, so it is neglected. So the only considerable point we can add is this one. So any perturbed or disturbed output is there, then that output will be considered as the nominal output. Whatever nominal output we are supposed to get, that will be the part, along with another term will be there in that perturbed output, that will be plus gain into the external perturbance. So whatever noise is there because of the external disturbance, so this disturbance will be providing some voltage, that will be multiplied by the gain of the circuit or gain of the inverter, and that will be added to get the overall disturbed output, whatever changed output is there. So from there we can see, like, the nominal output we cannot change, so it will be there, whatever input we have provided with respect to this input voltage will be there. But in case of the noise, it is having a term called gain. So this gain will be affecting the noise percentage or the noise effect. So whatever effect of noise will be there on the output, that will be also governed by the gain of the circuit. Okay, if this gain is less than 1, so suppose this gain is less than 1, then the noise effect will be minimum. Okay, okay, so if this gain is less than 1, then noise effect will be minimum. Okay, so we will be finding the voltage range, or the we will be making the analysis of the circuit such that the gain should be less than 1. Once we have made, like, the gain is less than 1, then we can reduce the effect of noise. So here is the magnitude of the voltage gain at a nominal input voltage V input. It is smaller than unity, then the input perturbance is not amplified and consequently the output perturbation remains relatively small. So suppose this is our characteristics. Okay, so we have seen like, so at this point and at this point the gain is almost zero. Okay, so at this region it is gain is zero, and at this region the gain is zero. So once gain is zero at this region and this region, then there will be very less effect of noise on this region, because the noise term that we are getting will be having multiplication of gain. So here gain is zero, so it will be having very less effect. So the only the effect of noise will be in this range, that is the transition region range. So in transition region range, the gain is not equals to zero. Okay, so it will be having some value and it is greater than like one. So that's why we will be considering the unity gain value beyond that. Okay, there otherwise we with the voltage gain larger than unity, a small perturbance in the input to voltage level will cause a rather large perturbance in the output voltage. So if the gain is larger than unity, so if a small variation is there in the input voltage, that will be resulting a higher variation into the output voltage. Hence we define the boundary of the valid input signal regions as the voltage points where the magnitude of the inverter voltage gain is equals to unity. So that's why we will be finding the range of inputs. So we will be defining a boundary of valid input signals that will be having the gain where the inverter gain will be equals to unity. So we will be finding out that. So this is your definition of all the voltages. So critical voltages that we will be defining is, this is VOH, VOL, VIL and VIH. So its definition is very important. Like VOH is there. So VOH is this value. Okay. So VOH gives like VOH is the maximum output. So maximum output voltage. So here we plot it, like suppose we have plotted it also. V output, V input is there, and this is okay. So VOH is there and VOL, and we call it the slope at this transition from high to some other value. So whatever slope is there, we will be finding out the slope. If slope is minus one, at this point we will be finding the input, and this input will be the VIL. We again find out the slope here. Just let me make it clear. Okay. So we will be finding out the point where the slope is minus one. Another point we will be finding out where the slope is minus one. Okay. So this point is considered as VIH, and this point where the slope is minus one, we will be considered as minus VIL. Okay. And this value is called your VOH. Okay. VOH. And the value, the range of well output between 0 to VOL, this will be considered as VOL value. Okay, so this is how the voltage terms, critical voltage parameters, are being defined. Okay. So why we have considered the point of the slope as minus 1 and minus 1 only, because after that whatever this slope will be there, that will be a higher value of slope. This region will be having a higher slope. So that's why we will be taking the input only in this range, that is up to a slope that is of minus 1. Similarly, the in output high will be considered only in this range where the slope of the curve is less than 1. The maximum value is 1, it is beyond that it will be less than 1. So in between the higher slope we will be avoiding the input range. So input range should not be there in this region because it will be providing higher slope, and this higher slope will be affecting the noise, will be affecting the output with higher noise. Okay, that's why we will be avoiding this. So from relation to this, the VOH will be given as the output maximum voltage when the output level is logic 1. So when the output logic is 1, then VOH will be the maximum output voltage. So VOH will be the maximum output voltage when the logic is at logic 1. VOL is the minimum. So this VOL is the minimum output voltage when the output logic is logic 0. Okay, this is the minimum, means this will be the range from 0 to VOL. So this will be the minimum output voltage when the logic will be considered as VOL. Similarly, the next is VIL. So VIL is the maximum input voltage. So this will be the maximum input voltage that can be considered as logic 0. Similarly, VIH will be considered as the minimum. So VIH will be considered as the minimum input voltage, which can be interpreted as logic 1. So in case of input, this is your input voltage. VIH will be the minimum input voltage that can be considered as logic high log. Okay. Similarly, in case of VIL, VIL is will be the maximum of the input low logic. So VIL will be the maximum input voltage which can be interpreted as logic 0. Okay, the similar way we can call it for VIL and VIH also. Okay, so the next is the power consideration. So in case of digital circuits, we will be considering the DC power dissipation. So the total power dissipation we will be considering later in the course. So this DC power dissipation of an inverter is given by PDC. We represented PDC is equals to whatever VDD is there and whatever current at DC analysis. So at steady state, what will be the DC current flowing through the inverter circuit? That will be multiplied by the VDD, the total supply voltage, will be considered as the DC power dissipation. Okay, so whatever DC power dissipation is there, that will be given by VDD into IDC. And similarly, the current depends upon the input and output voltage levels. Assume the voltage levels 50% is at logic 0 and 50% at logic 1. So from there, so what happens, this current will be changing in the analysis, like inverter is there. So for 50% duration, it is at logic 0, and 50% duration, this is logic 1 and this is 0. So for 50% duration, it is at logic 1, and 50% duration, it is logic 0. So we will be dividing it, this current, into two parts, like, and we will be taking an average. So whatever current is there, IDC is there, when V input is low logic. So whatever current is there when V input is at low logic, okay, so this is low, and then again we will be finding out the current for V input at the high logic, and we will be adding these two and divide it by two. So this will be the another way to give the power dissipation. Okay, so we have just considered the 50% contribution by logic 1 and 50% contribution by logic 0. And the chip area. So chip area is basically provided by, in digital circuit, is basically provided by the gate area. Okay, so whatever gate area is there, so whatever area of gate is there, that will be given by W into L. W is the channel width, L is the channel length. whatever length and width is there, based on that we will be finding out the area. Or another way to find out the area is, in case of digital circuits, basically we do is by finding out the number of transistors used. So if any circuit is there that is having suppose 10 number of transistors, so its area could be represented in like the 10 number of transistors, or the complexity of a circuit can be represented in terms of number of transistors also. Okay, so here number of transistors could be used to represent the area, chip area, in a symbolic form. Okay, but the exact way will be by using by summing the total transistors area, individual area. This is one way, simple way. Another one is simple way. The exact way will be, another one is exact way. This exact way is finding out the area of the chip, area of chip after designing its layout. Okay, so whatever layout of the circuit is there, after designing the layout, what will be the area of the chip? We call it active area. Whatever active area is there, that will be considered as the exact area of a particular chip. So in general we use this method, first one, or some in some of the research papers you can could find number of transistors as the complexity or the area consideration, area point of view we call it the number of transistors. Okay, so from the next onwards, there are different type of inverter loads are there. So we will be seeing, so based on resistive load, depletion load, enhancement load, and CMOS inverter. So one by one we will be seeing all these inverters. So from the next class we will be seeing like what is resistive load inverters. Okay, so we will close for today. If you are having any point, you can ask. Yes.